Hello friends, welcome to Learner's Planet. Friends, in this session we are going to discuss concepts and problems related to cubes. Once again, an important topic of nonverbal reasoning portion. See, questions based on cubes are asked in various aptitude based and reasoning based examination. Maybe you talk about bank examination and various MBA entrance examinations, and the topic is really very easy. You need to develop some sort of visualization to solve the problems based on cubes. Now here you can see various types of cubes. This is 2 by 2. That means there will be 8 cubes, 2 height, 2 length and 2 width. So that is 2 into 2 into 2. These are 8 cubes. Similarly, we can see here 3 by 3 by 3, that means 3 into 3 into 3, there will be 27 cubes of side 1 by 1 by 1, right? You can assume the sides to be, the smaller cube sides to be 1 centimeter by 1 centimeter and by 1 centimeter. So in all, the total size of this cube is 3 centimeter by 3 centimeter by 3 centimeter. Right, so the each smaller cube will be having the volume as 1 centimeter cube, and the bigger one, the entire cube, will be having the volume as 27 centimeter cube, that is 3 into 3 into 3. Similarly, it is 4 centimeter by 4 centimeter by 4 centimeter, so 4 into 4 into 4, that is 64 cubic centimeter, that will be the volume of the entire cube, and each small cube will have the volume as 1. Okay, 1 by 1 by 1, and in all there will be 64 pieces. Similarly, this we can see 5 by 5 by 5. So 5 into 5 into 5, there will be 125 smaller cubes in this bigger one. And the volume of each smaller one will be 1 centimeter cube, and the bigger one will be having 125 centimeter cube. Now friends, cube is a three-dimensional figure that we can see very well. It is length, breadth and height. Okay, now I just discussed the various component over here. See these, this and this, right? These sort of corners are called vertices, right? These lines are actually edges. Okay, and this combination of four, these are called faces of the cubes. So in all, in a cube, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7, and that one another one is hidden, in all 8 vertices are there. Edges 1 2 3 4 4 at the bottom and 4 these sides, right? So 12 edges will be there, and 1, 2, 3 and opposite ones. So in all there will be 6 faces. Okay, so these 3D figure, all in fact not a cube, all the 3D figures maintain a relationship, that is vertex plus faces is equal to edges plus 2. Vertices plus faces is equal to edges plus 2. That is 8 plus 6, that is 14, and this is 12 plus 2, that's 14, right? So this is an important relationship, and you must be knowing vertices, edges and faces. Particularly in this session, we'll be discussing more about faces. Now let's discuss which type of questions are asked in examination. Now what happens, maybe a question reads, if a cube is painted on all its surfaces with a color, or maybe more than one color, or maybe opposite sides are painted in the same color, then the bigger cube is divided into smaller cubes of equal size, right? Then after separations, a number of smaller cubes are obtained, and questions are based on that. Okay. So for that, you need to develop visualization power, and that power will be developed only through practice. Okay, so what happens exactly? See, there sometimes a question is just a single question based on a cube, right? So if it is a single question, it's not worth drawing the figure. If there are 4 to 5 questions associated with a single cube, then it is worth to draw a figure. So some of your time can be saved, that is getting into visualization. okay, because sometimes it becomes difficult for you to visualize the scenes. Okay, so two main important things are there. The first one is how to draw a cube, okay, and the others to find out the layers, total number of cubes, and identify the faces. Okay, so let's first of all discuss the different types of layers in a cube. So here I'm having a cube that is of 5 centimeter by 5 centimeter by 5 centimeter, right? So if we cut this cube into equal smaller cubes, I'll be getting 5 into 5 into 5, that is 125 smaller cubes, right? Now what we can name the layers. This is top layer, this is bottom layer, these three are middle layer, right? So I just name them top layer, bottom, this is middle one, this is middle two, this is middle three. You can also choose name according to your choice. So whichever the name you are taking into practice, the same name should be continued in your examination, right? So the things will be clear in your mind. Okay, so here I'm using top, bottom, middle one, middle two, middle three. Okay. Now, as I have already told you that if a single question is there, you should not draw the figure. But if four to five questions are there based on a single cube, then it is worth drawing a figure. So I just describe how to draw a figure. First of all, what you do, you just draw a square like this. Then a line that should be 45 degree, around 45 degree from this. Okay, so I just draw that. Okay, the second line that is parallel to this, join them. Next is a line parallel to this line to approx 50% of the length, then match the remaining ones. Okay, this is the basic cube. After that, number of partition, whatever you require, you can draw accordingly, right? You need to just take care of one thing, that the lines should be drawn parallel to these lines, right? Suppose this. See, I'm using tools of Word, but in case of your examination, you'll be directly using your pen or pencil so that the method will be faster, right? As of now, it's taking time. I just wish to maintain the neatness. Okay, so this is how you can draw the lines. Similarly, over here, the lines should be parallel to these lines. Okay, this way. Then, horizontal partition, this way. Doesn't matter if some unevenness is there. So this way you can draw this. Okay, now that's enough for us. Okay, if this cube is of 3 by 3, then according to this, and if cube is 4 by 4, then according to that you need to draw the parallel lines. Okay, so before going to examination, just practice with some of the figures. Okay, so in the time of examination, you'll be able to draw them very quickly. Okay, now this is the cube of 3 by 3 by 3. Now this one, this is what the outer layer. See, if you color the entire cube, this face, this and this, they will be having this four cube from the top layer will be having two sides colored, right? This you can see. The same thing will be there and here and in that case, right? So these pieces will be having two sides colored. Okay. You can assume this length to be 1 centimeter. So this is actually the outer layer. right? From this outer layer, the middle portions will be having two sides colored, right? After that, these corner pieces, they will be having three sides colored. Three sides, three sides, three sides, three side. Okay, I just write. These are two sides colored, two sides colored, two sides colored. This is 3, 3, 3, 3. And the remaining, this will be single side colored, right? Now the same thing will happen with all the faces, okay? So we'll learn to calculate, but as of now, it should be clear in your mind, right? The corner pieces will be having three sides colored, maybe same, maybe different, depends upon the individual question. The middle pieces will be having two sides colored and the center piece will be having single colored, okay? The same thing will happen with the 4 by 4 by 4 cube. Let's see here. 1, 2, 3, 4. This four pieces from the top layer will be having three sided colored. 3, 3, 3, 3. Then this 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, right? And the center pieces, that will be 1, 1, 1, and 1, right? The same thing will happen with 5 by 5, 6 by 6, any number by any number, okay? Any number by that same number, in fact. Here I'm having 5 by 5 by 5. So this is 3 colored, 3 colored, 3 sided colored, 3 sided color, 3 sided. This is 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2. 2, 2, 2, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. Precisely, how would you calculate? Just leave the outer layer. How many corners are there? There are four corners. That means four pieces will be there on the top layer of three sides colored, right? How many middle pieces? In all, there are five pieces in one line. So three pieces are the two are corners. So three are middle pieces. So the three middle pieces from each edge, right, will be having two sided color. So two, this one piece, two piece, three piece, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, right? So 12 pieces from the top layer, we are just talking about the top layer, so they will be having two sides colored, right? And the remaining, they will be having just one side colored, okay? Now we'll take a problem and discuss the things in detail. Offense, here I would like to share a quick tip on how to calculate the number of cubes when zero faces are painted. That means no face is painted. One face is painted, two faces painted, and three faces painted, right? This is one example over here. I have already written the number. See, for zero faces painted, you count at last, right? For three faces painted, you just count the number of vertices. That's always four in any cube, right? So 4 on the top layer, this is the top layer, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. In this case, there are 5 layers, so in top layer and bottom layer, right? So in top layer, 4 pieces are there, and in bottom layer, 4 pieces are there. So in every cube, 3 sides color, whether it is a 5 by 5 or 3 by 3 or a 4 by 4 or maybe 6 by 6, right? Only 8 cubes will be having 3 sides colored. Now this color may be different, may be same, may or may not be. Okay, whatever that depends upon the individual questions. Okay, now for two faces painted, you need to count the number of edges. Okay, now number of edges are also fixed in each and every cube, right? In each and every cube, as I've already told you, there are 12 edges. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and the backside, and 4 at the bottom. So 12 edges are there. Right, and each edge, two pieces are except the first and the last, all the pieces are colored for two times. There are, or I can say, two faces are colored. So in this case, three. Okay, on this edge, three cubes are having two faces colored. So in all, we are having 12 edges. Each edge is having three sides colored. So in this case, particularly, 12 into 3. Okay. So if it is of a cube of 4 by 4, then there will be 12 into 2. If it is 3 by 3, then 12 into 1, right? So similarly, so in case of when we are talking two faces painted, we calculate using number of edges. When we have to calculate three sides, three faces painted, then we see vertex. And when we have to see one side, one face is painted, then we have to see faces. Now faces is top, these are faces. Now each face is having, just remove the left one, remove the right one, just take the center part, right? Just leave the 1 centimeter boundary, okay? So in this case, this 3 by 3 circle, 3 by 3 square you'll be getting, right? From each face. So from each face, you'll be getting 9 pieces and there are 6 faces. So 9 into 6, 54. Okay, so 54 pieces will be having, or 54 cubes will be having one face as painted. Okay, now out of total 125, if you deduct everything, you'll be getting 0 sides painted. That means the cubes which are having no, none of their faces as painted. So that's 27. Okay, if it is 4 by 4, then also it is very simple. I just calculate it for you in a moment. For 4 by 4, just draw the top layer. That's it. Okay. 3, 2, 1, 0. Three faces, three sides colored with all the four corner pieces of top layer and bottom layer. 8. Okay. Then two faces are colored of edges. So this 2 on single edge. So 2 into 12 edges are there. So 24 pieces will be having two faces as painted. 1, that's 4 from each face. So there are 6 pieces, so these are there also 24. Out of total 64, this is 24 plus 24, 48. 48 plus 8 is 56. So that's 8 pieces will be having no color at all. Okay, so this way you can quickly calculate them. Okay, for 3, vertex you have to see. For 2, edges you have to see. For 1, faces you have to see. That's it. Okay, vertex, edges and faces. Okay, now let's see this first one, a set of 4 questions, a simple one. A cube is colored red on all its faces. It is then cut into 64 smaller cubes of equal sizes. The smaller cubes so obtained are now separated. Now various questions are there. So first of all, let's find out the number of cubes having a single side, double side, no side and three side sides are painted. Okay, for that initially we will be taking the help of a cube. After that, after some practice, you don't have to draw the cube for these sort of simple questions. Okay, so let's take a cube of 4 by 4 by 4. That is 4 into 4 into 4. That is 64. Okay, so that means 64 smaller cubes are there. That means the size of cube is 4 centimeter by 4 centimeter by 4 centimeter. Okay, now what we do? 0, 1, 2, 3, right? 0, zero faces are painted of a smaller cube, 1 face, 2 face and 3, right? Now, as I've already told you, the corner pieces will each of them will be having 3 sides colored, right? So 1, 2, 3, 4 and 4 from the bottom. So in all, 8 pieces will be there. Okay, after that, 2 sides. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 from the top, 8 from the bottom. So in all it is 16. After that, here also. Okay, so 4 from this side and 4 from that side, because this we have already considered while we will discussing these, because they are common. Okay, so 8 from the top, 8 from the bottom, 16 plus 4 this side, 4 that side. So in all it is 24. Okay, now 1. From each face, 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 pieces are there having single side painted or single face painted. In all, there are 6 sides. So, 4 on each side or each face. So, 4 into 6, 24, right? Now, 24 plus 24 is 48. 48 plus 8 is 56. In all, there are 64. So, remaining 8 are having no face as painted. Okay, so 8, 24, 24 and 8. Now we are done. So it's 0, 1, 2, 3, 8, 24, 24, 8. Now let's answer. How many smaller cubes will have no face colored? 0, that's 8. How many smaller cubes will have at least 2 surface painted with red color? At least 2, that means 2 and more. That means 2 or 3. So 24 plus 8, 32. Okay. How many smaller cubes have 2 surfaces painted with red color? So that's 24. How many smaller cubes have only 3 surfaces painted with red color? That's 8. Okay, how much time we have taken to solve all this question? Just 30 seconds we can answer all the 4 questions if we have found out this clearly. Okay, let's try the next one. Now, a cube is painted red on 2 adjacent surfaces and black on the surfaces opposite to red surfaces and green on the remaining faces. Now, the cube is cut into 64 smaller cubes of equal size. Now, friends, all the 6 faces are colored and opposite faces, just a moment, 2 adjacent surfaces, red on 2 adjacent, I just draw the top view only. Now actually these 2 adjacent surfaces, so I take this as red, this is red, then black on surfaces opposite to red, so this is black, and green on the remaining, right? So this is green and bottom is also green. Okay, now once again 64 smaller cubes will be there. Now first of all, what we do, 0, as we discussed in the previous case, that is no sides colored or no faces colored, will be 8. Okay, now one surface will be 4 from each side. Okay, so maybe of any color. So 4 from this, 4, this, this, this and bottom. So in all, one face colored will be 24. 2 face colored will be 24 as we have discussed. And 3 faces will be 8 corners, right? Irrespective of colors, we have written this. Okay, now depends upon individual question, then we'll calculate further. The first question is, how many smaller cubes have only one surface painted? Irrespective of color, there are 24 cubes. Okay, now how many smaller cubes will have no surface painted? So that's 8. Okay, how many smaller cubes have less than 3 surface painted? That means 0, 1 and 2. So 24 and 24, 48 plus 8. Okay, less than 3 surfaces, that means 1 and 2 only. So 24 plus 24, 48. Okay. How many smaller cubes have 3 surfaces painted? So that's 8. Okay, now difficult ones. How many smaller cubes with 2 surfaces painted have one face green and one of the adjacent face black or red? That means we have to find out green, black and green, red. Now this one, how many smaller cubes have at least one surface painted with green color? Now we know the top face and the bottom face, both of them are colored in green, right? So maybe corner pieces are may have more than one color, but every piece, that means top 16 pieces will be having at least one green side. Okay, this. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 by 4, 16 top and 16 bottom, right? Because top face is green and bottom face is also green. So in all, 32 cubes will be there. They will be having at least one face as green. Okay, so isn't it so easy? Now see this one. Here, the outer border of width 1 centimeter of a cube with 5 centimeter is painted yellow. On each side and the remaining space enclosed by this is 1 centimeter path is painted pink. So this is yellow and this entire area is pink. Okay. The smaller cube now separated. Okay. So first of all, let's find out zero faces colored 1, 2 and 3, right? Three faces, the four corner pieces are they are having the vertex. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Four from the top layer and four from the bottom layer. In all, eight pieces will be there with three sides colored. Which color? That will decide later on, but as of now, we discuss this much only. They will be having three faces colored. After that, now these pieces, they are having an edge, right? That you can see. Okay, so 3, 3, 3, 3, right? How many edges are there in a cube? There are 12 edges. Okay, from each edge, three pieces are colored. Or having two sides colored, I mean to say. So in all, there are 36. Then one, the center pieces, 1, 2, 3, 4, 3 into 3, 9. 9 from each face. Now there are 6 faces, so 9 from each face. So 9 into 6, 54. Right? Now in all there are 125. So 54 plus 36, that's 90, plus 8, 98. So we are left with 27, with no faces colored. Okay. So I just make a quick recap over here. One, that one is obtained from faces. Two is obtained from edges, and three is obtained from vertices. Okay. Then it will be easier for you. Just choose the number of, find out the number of corners, find out the number of edges, find out the number of faces. That's it. Okay. Now the first one, how many smaller cubes have all the surfaces uncolored? 0, that's 27. How many smaller cubes have three surfaces colored yellow? See, all the corner pieces are yellow colored and they are having three faces as colored, that we have already calculated. So in all there are 8 pieces, right? How many smaller cubes have at least two surfaces colored yellow, right? Now two surfaces colored yellow, though the cubes which are having which are positioned at the edges. So 1, 2, 3, two surfaces are colored. So in fact, this entire line, right? So we can say 36 plus 8, that is 44. 36 with two sides yellow and two faces yellow, and 8 with three faces yellow. So 36 plus 8, so that's 44. Okay. Now, how many smaller cubes have one face colored pink and an adjacent face yellow? That means one face should be pink and other should be yellow. So we don't have any option like this, because the only pieces which are in center will be having pink color as one of their face, and they will be having just single face colored. Okay, so in all there are 54 pieces, but they don't have their adjacent or any other faces yellow, because they are just having a single colored face. Okay, so precisely that is 0. Okay, now how many smaller cubes have at least one face colored? Okay, so from entire 125 deduct 27, so that's 98 pieces will be having at least one surface colored. Okay, isn't it so simple? Once you have found these details, after that the problem is very easy. In all, this sort of question will not take more than 2 to 3 minutes to solve, 5 to 6 questions. Okay. Now let's try this one here. Friends, there are 10 questions in this set, so it is worth drawing the preliminary figure. The solid cube has been painted yellow, blue and black on the pair of opposite surfaces. So I assume, say, this to be blue, this to be black, and this front face, this blue is top, this is black, top and bottom is blue, then this and this is black, right hand side is black, and front face is yellow. Okay, this one and the back side, so this one is yellow. Okay, now the cube is then cut into 36 smaller cubes such that 32 cubes are of the same size while 4 other are of bigger size. Also, no face of any of the bigger cubes is painted blue. Okay, exactly what is happening? This cube is being cut into equal portion first of all, and thus one portion is further cut into 16 smaller pieces, right? See, in each layer 16 pieces are there. 16, 16, 16, 16, right? Out of that, two layers are as it is, okay? So that's 32 pieces, and the remaining two, they have cut, or we have cut only 4 pieces, okay? So in all, 36 pieces are there. That means this bigger cubes must be having the size 2 by 2 by 2, right? Suppose this is one of the cube, this one. Okay, now we have to take care of one thing over here. None of the bigger cubes, any face of them is blue, right? That means what is the possibility? See, top and bottom, both of them are yellow, right? The only thing, the only area we are left with is the middle portion. Okay. So 1, 2 and 3 and backside this. Okay. 4. 4 pieces will be there when they will be having yellow or black but no blue. Okay. So we have to go like this way only. The diagram is not so neat, but I'm sure you are able to understand. Okay. This is 2 by 2 by 2, the back side. This is also 2 by 2 by 2, the back side. And so similarly, 2 pieces are there on the back side. Okay. So this is what the structure. Remaining these pieces are of 1 by 1 size. Okay. Now, precisely we are having 4 bigger cubes and 32 smaller. Right? Now, let's take questions one by one. Now, how many cubes have at least one face painted black? So, pretty simple. Let's see this face and then we will double the calculation. 4 here. 4 here, the smaller ones, 8, the bigger one, 8 and 2, 10, and 10 this side from this layer, just concentrate over here. This is the rightmost layer, and similarly, the same number will be from this layer also, because the opposite sides are black, right? So at least one surface will be black. So in all, 10 this side, 10 this side, okay? So in all, this are 20, okay? Out of this 20, 16 are smaller ones and 4 are bigger ones. Okay. After that, how many cubes have only one face painted? Now, once again, a simple one. See, all the bigger pieces will be having two surfaces painted. For example, this one. So, this will be from this side and this side. So, these two faces will be colored. Okay, but we want only one. That means we need to choose from the smaller squares, right? That means from the top and from the bottom. Now top 4, 1, 2, 3, 4 and bottom 4, 4 and 4, 8. So there will be 8 cubes with only one face painted. Okay, now that one. How many cubes have only two faces painted? Okay, let's see. So two faces, all the 4. 1, 2, the 4 bigger ones. So that's 4 plus in smaller at each edge 2 pieces are there. So 4 edges from the top layer. So 4 into 2, 8 and 4 from the bottom layer. Right? So 8 and 8, 16. 16 plus this 4, 20. Okay? Getting my point? At each edge, we can see two cubes will be having two faces as colored. Okay, so top in the top layer there are 4 edges. Each edge is having 2 cubes. That means 8 and 8 from the bottom layer. Right, this is the bottom layer. Okay, so 16 plus 4 bigger ones, in all 20. Now, how many cubes have two or more faces painted? So two or more, that means inclusive of 2. 2 we have already calculated. Now let's calculate 3. So 3 for 3, we should be having the corner cubes. So 20 we already have with two faces painted, and 8 corners are there. So 8 pieces will be having 3 sides painted, right? This 1, 2, 3, 4, 8 from top layer, 8 from bottom, sorry, 4 from top layer, 4 from bottom layer. So in all 20 plus 8, 28, right? Now this one, how many cubes have only 3 faces painted? We have just calculated the top of from top layer 4 and from bottom layer 4. So in all it is 8. Okay. Now how many painted cubes do not have any of their faces painted yellow? That means no yellow we want. So let's see. So front and back both of them are yellow. So top and bottom can be chosen, right? And even from this and that also be chosen. So let's see. The pieces from edges 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 from top, 4 from bottom, right? Apart from that, the central pieces 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 from top, 4 from bottom, right? So precisely 8 from top, 8 from bottom. 16 are there. And the middle ones are actually bigger cubes, so they are having either this side yellow or the back side yellow, right? So in all we just have 16 cubes with us without yellow. Okay. Now how many cubes have at least one of their faces painted black? Let's see. So all the four bigger, they will be having one side as black for sure. And from the smaller ones, see with this entire face is black and the other face is also black. So 1, 2, 3, 4 from the top layer, 4 from the bottom layer. They will be having one side as black. So 4 and 4, 8 from this layer and similarly 8 from that layer. So 8 and 8, 16 and 4 bigger cubes. So in all it is 20. Okay, 16 smaller pieces and 4 bigger one, so in all it is 20. Okay, getting me? Now how many cubes have at least one of their faces painted blue? Let's see. So it's very easy to answer, the entire top layer and the entire bottom layer. So 16 pieces from the top layer and 16 pieces from the bottom layer. In all 32 pieces will be there having at least one side as blue. Now why it is happening? Because the remaining four this bigger pieces they don't have blue color, right? So the entire set of top layer and bottom layer is blue. Okay, so in all 32. Now this one, how many cubes have no face painted? Now that's once again very simple to answer. Now friends, see, top layer is colored, bottom layer is colored, right? And the middle one, they are combination of two pieces. So we don't have even a single piece that is having no color, right? If these pieces are of one by one, then the middle layer and the middle one and middle two layer could have the center pieces without any color, but in this case there is no scope of colorless pieces. Getting my point? Because top layer is completely colored, bottom layer is completely colored, and the central layer are combination of two, so there will their faces in fact their two faces will be colored. Okay, this one and that one, this one and this one. Okay, so we don't have any cube, not smaller, neither smaller nor bigger, without any color. Okay, now how many cubes have only two face painted, one yellow and other black? That means yellow and black we have to find out. Okay, now we want only yellow black. That means we need to choose the bigger pieces. So there are four bigger pieces. So two sides of them will be one of them will be yellow and other of them will be black. So this is yellow, then this will be black in this particular piece if we talk about. Okay. So such four pieces are there. So they will be having only yellow and black with two-sided color only. Okay. So in all there are four pieces. Okay, you see that the problems are really very easy once you have prepared this diagram and the basic information is with you, right? So I'm sure you'll be now comfortable with the simple problems based on cubes. In our next session, we'll be taking some complicated problems when the cubes are cut and many other problems. So do revise this session before you come for the next session. Bye-bye.